You need all five guys on the same page here tonight, folks. There's not going to be any softies. Both teams are going to leave it all on the ice. You know that. And not a lot to play for tomorrow if you're the Deer Lake Red Wings. You give it all tonight in the CB Stairs. They're going to come back. Face off one back to French. Moore shoots. Gets through all the way. There's Crosby. The chance. Scores! Chris Crosby on the rebound. Buckles the twine. And the CB Stairs take a 1-0 lead here in game six. You win the crucial face-off. Back to the point it goes. The shot gets through, and Crosby finds the back of the net.
Don't tell me face-offs aren't an important part of the game, Patty. That looked to be a set play off the power play. Here you see the draw go back right away. They eventually find Big Ian Moores in the middle of the ice. This is a set play. Nice low, hard shot, rebound. Easiest pie for Crosby. 1-0 Seabees.
Nice play by Ryan Delaney. Puts Dalton on the board. Here's Ray Dalton with a giveaway. Legged it back in front and collected by Delaney with some open ice. And here he comes. He looks wide to Sean Wan. Wan, Delaney. Keith Delaney all alone. He scores! Keith Delaney, 2-0 CB Stars. What a beauty!
That's what happens when you have top-end skill. The Deer Lake Red Wings probably had their best pressure in a hockey game so far. One good play by defenseman, a hit behind the net, outlet pass, and here they go. Skill beats will there in this situation. Sean Martin with a great pass to Delaney. Lovely finish here on the end. Watch this. Dunn doesn't have a chance. He sold backhand, forehand in the net.
Keith Delaney with the moves that everyone in the province knows he has. He comes back to play this time of year and puts his team up 2-0. 16:26 remaining in the second period. You throw 6,000 people in the middle of April, you're going to get some funny bounces. Crosby controls. There's also a chance. Wide open. There's Bradley. Oh, Stu Dunn. Stu Dunn. Another great save. Kept in by Crosby. He knocks it in though. He goes all the way behind Dunn and Bradley's on it. Bradley looks down. He's fine. Oh, it's right in front. There's Crosby. He scores. You can't stop them all. Stewart and Chris Crosby finds the top corner. His second of the night is 3-0 CBs.
Patty, once again, Dunn does his best, but the Seabees, with good old-fashioned hard work, find a way to solve them. It might take four shots, it might take five, but they're going to find a way to get it done. You see here, good hard work turns the puck over once again. Bartlett goes behind the net, finds it wide open. Crosby, no mistake there from that slot.
Right up top shelf where Daddy keeps the Playboys, which he reads the articles only, ladies and gentlemen. 3-0 Seabees Stars. The place is full of CB fans here tonight, and they're loving it. And of course, the Deer Lake Red Wings, they've got to slow down this offensive onslaught. Timeout called by the Red Wings just to collect and rally the troops. 3-0, it's not over, folks. But guarantee you, Deer Lake know on their bench, you got to get back in this hockey game. And the first way to do that is all for one, one for all. And who's leading the charge on the bench? 24, Darren Langdon. French plays it out in the middle of the rink where it's collected by Mikhailov, who's been on the ice all night here tonight. Knocked off his stick by Bala. Bala plays it around for Barker. Barker controls. Nice play by the veteran. Barker turns back, finds some time, and plays it to Mikhailov. Across to Parsons. Paul Parsons looks across for Rob Robinson. Pass way ahead of him. Oh, there's a chance in front, and they score! Rob Robinson! Gives a little bit of life to the Deer Lake Red Wings. Exactly what the Seabees could not have. 2:54 remaining. Shorthanded goal by Rob Robinson.
Good effort there by Rob down behind the net. You see it happen here. Deer Lake, Seabees look to be under total control, but a blind giveaway there. Just tucks it back home. Freddie Diamond's not ready for that as well, as the Seabees had 100% of the puck. Just gave it away. No quit here in the Deer Lake team. 2:54 left. They need another quickie.
Reardon looking for a loose puck controlled by Big Mark Robinson. Oh, Keith Delaney. He's going to have a chance to move it up the boards to Jeff Oates. Oates in wide open net. And there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. Jeff Oates has just secured the CB Stars, their third straight Telegraph Hurling Memorial Championship trophy. And it's bedlam here in Mile One Center. It's all over, but the crying out for the Red Wings. That's it, the Seabees have managed to hold on here, and they're going to win this one in six games.
Jubilation down on the Stars bench, the trainers, the coaches, the players. There's about nine guys in the hallway with Stars jerseys on that were wishing they got the opportunity to play tonight. Guys like Chris Sparks, Danny Cadigan, They're all here. Everybody's excited. Watch out tonight in Harbour Grace.
Watch out in Harbour Grace. And ladies and gentlemen, Model 1 Centre has been the host of a lot of great hockey games and a lot of great hockey moments. And tonight, yet another chapter is written into the illustrious tale of the Hurler Memorial Championship, and the CB Stars on the cusp of bringing home their third straight to the faithful in Harbour Grace and Concepcion Bay North, who are without question on their feet in their living rooms, tears in their eyes, cheering for the famous CB Stars. Eddie Barlett up the boards, 28 seconds to go. Knocked down, Brian Barker holds on. Steve Power, thanks for your contribution to our broadcast tonight. And ladies and gentlemen, thank you to Rogers Cable and Eastlink for being our sponsors and being able to broadcast Game 6 of their honor to over 450 communities in Newfoundland. And you've just seen the Concepcion Bay North CB Stars in their third straight honor. Congratulations to the Blue played a great game here tonight. And certainly congratulations to the Deer Lake Red Wings, who season after season make it to the verge of collecting the Herder. But once again, they fall to their foe, the CB Stars. It's been a great evening of hockey here on Rogers Television. We sure hope you enjoyed the broadcast. And this familiar sight, one team sad, one team in ecstasy, helmets and gloves and sticks all over the ice, and Darren Langdon waiting at the blue line to shake hands at what we hope can be a peaceful end to what has been another raucous affair here at Model 1 Centre. Here comes Chris Barlett to meet the captain. There you go.
That's a classy act there by Darren Langdon. Hey, the buzzer's gone. Buzzer's gone. The game's over. Langdon leads the way.
Let's see. Let's make sure this just goes without incident. Darren Langdon's a professional guy. He's congratulating what was the better team on this night. Gamber gets a little special pat on the back. Well done yourself, Darren. I'm going to let Steve Power wrap it up here from the gondola while I go back down to join Steve Callahan. Steve Power, great job tonight. Thanks for being part of it. I'll be back with you in about 30 seconds.
Thanks, Patty. As you see both teams shaking hands there after a hard-fought victory for the Stars, this is what Newfoundland senior hockey is about. Heart, emotion, pride, passion. It's something that's been missing here at Mile 1 to Wild, but you see it here tonight. The home team Stars and their faithful. Maybe a lot of people in the rink don't follow senior hockey all year, but you know something, right now they don't care. All you care about is the gloves, the helmets, the sticks littered all over the ice, and the hardware about to be presented. Congratulations to the CB Stars 2008 Herder Memorial Trophy champions.